NASCAR drivers are not accessible to their fans. That's what a lot of you are saying, but if you listen to driver opinions from Joey Logano or even other opinions like my own, I would have to disagree with that statement. Hear me out. Whether you like Joey Logano or not, he made some pretty valid points on Sirius XM today talking about how NASCAR's athlete access as opposed to other major sports is pretty monumental, especially if you compare it to the NFL. Logano talked about how before an event, before a game for the NFL, the likelihood of meeting your favorite athlete or a football player in general is close to zero. As for NASCAR, before a race, there is ample opportunity to meet your favorite driver, whether it's in the fan zone, when they're doing an interview, whether it's on the red carpet, before they go out to driver introductions, or even too if it's at a local Walmart, making an appearance before the race weekend even starts. So compared to the NFL, things look pretty good for NASCAR, but when we compare it to the other motorsports in the United States, such as IndyCar, IMSA, and even to the NHRA, NASCAR's access starts to look a lot more slim. From what you all have told me on social media, once you get an NHRA ticket, it kind of acts as an all-access pass. I can speak to my experience in IndyCar, as I did get a pass for my weekend at Mid-Ohio, but literally I felt like nothing was off limits. I was able to meet so many drivers. In NASCAR, I feel like that opportunity would have been a little bit barred. I feel like in IndyCar, the drivers weren't trying to avoid the fans. They kind of welcomed the fans at the track. I know that they go on their little scooters and they scooter around the track. But as for NASCAR, I feel like sometimes the drivers actively try to avoid the fans. And I know there's many reasons behind why. But I get that vibe in NASCAR versus IndyCar where things seem much open, but I also think there's a reason for that. Popularity-wise, NASCAR is much larger in scale as compared to IndyCar, IMSA, and the NHRA, even if you look at TV viewership numbers. And it makes sense when there's a more popular sport that the access is going to be a lot more limited. There's going to be a little bit more scarcity, whether it's for security reasons, whether it's just to limit access, because if we let everyone get a pit pass, the garage area would be overflowed. And remember, that's a place of work. So if we overflow that area, we get in the way of these teams and these drivers, it's going to cause chaos and it's going to make things a lot less efficient. All this to say, I know that there are NHRA races, IMSA races, IndyCar races that sell out and they still have more access. So granted, that is a very fair point. I will say though, a few years ago, pre-COVID, access in NASCAR was a lot more free, I would say. From my experience as a fan, having the ability to get hot passes before 2020 was a lot easier than it is now. A lot of tracks have gotten rid of hot passes, which allows you to be on pit road during the race. You really now have to know a guy or you have to win a contest to be able to get those passes as opposed to just buying them on the track's website, which then creates a barrier of having to pay to play essentially as a fan. And of course, the prices to go to these races has increased over the years. The ability to pay to get a VIP experience has kind of gone away. And if you want to get it, it's a lot more expensive. Now, the really only accessible way to be able to get on pit road during a NASCAR weekend is to buy a pre-race pass where you're able to go to the front of the stage for driver introductions. That's a great time for you to try to get your autographs as the drivers are going to the stage. You have access to be able to be around the red carpet that the drivers walk to go to driver introductions. But after driver introductions are done, the fans are ushered away. So it's kind of a win-lose situation, but I think COVID presented an opportunity for NASCAR to kind of relook the access to the drivers, whether it was for safety and health reasons or other reasons, and try to figure out a different system. As a side note as well, I think in the future, I would love for NASCAR to better specify their passes. There are VIP passes and media passes, and often those two can get confused. So whether it's we make more specific passes for certain things, I would love that, but that's besides the point. All of this said, though, I do also think it has to do with how we all define access, how we define that lack of access to our drivers. Do we say that there's a lack of access because I couldn't meet my favorite driver 3 out of the 5 races I attended this year? Do we say it's a lack of access because I didn't get to give my favorite driver a high five? I didn't get an autograph? Was it lack of access because I was standing 50 feet away from my favorite driver as they were giving an interview as opposed to 10 feet away? It all is a little subjective in how we define that lack of access. Sometimes you feel like the drivers might be trying to avoid you. Sometimes it is those times where you get to access these drivers is more limited than it was before. So if we're comparing it to where it was before, things seem a lot more scarce. And before you all go into the comments and comment this, I'm going to address this here. Yes, I work at the track as a media member most of the time. So I get passes through that. But that is because I am working. I'm interviewing. I'm writing articles. It's not me to get autographs. One, that's frowned upon. Two, it's a work environment. I'm not going to do that working. So I get my opinion could come from a place of I go into the garage area more than a lot of folks that will watch this video. So it might be a little bit of a biased or tainted opinion. But also pre-2022, I was a fan in the stands. I was watching the races. I wanted to have that interaction with the drivers, and any chance I could, I would go to those Walmart meetups. I would go to the pre-race interviews and try to get to the front of the stage. Like, I was in those shoes before, so I can understand from all opinions how this could all be perceived. I understand from all sides of the story. Do you think there's enough access? Is there enough access? Is there not? But the start of this argument was that fans said we have awful access to our athletes, and I think if we're saying that, that's kind of bogus. I think compared to other major sports in the United States, NASCAR has exceptional access to our athletes. Now, if we compare it again to other motorsports, I think NASCAR could improve. Part of me wants to go back to where we were pre-COVID, but I also understand there's a reason why we're doing things the way we are now. But what do you think about these comments about NASCAR athletes not being accessible? Let me know in the comments below. If you want more great motorsports content, make sure to click the videos on the screen and the links in the description.